Shalom avracha, good morning, achenu b'nei Yisrael, white show members of Mispalim, and beloved Klal Yisrael. So here we are in the middle of Sfiras HaOmer, starting from the second night of Pesach, and of course, how do we begin? Hayom yom echad laomer, yom echad baomer. And the question that, of course, beckons our scrutiny is, what do you mean yom echad? If you're counting towards something, you're counting towards Maimon Har Sinai. Anytime we count in sequence, we always commence with the expected yom rishon. It's yom rishon, it's yom rishon, it's yom sheni. And this is a question, of course, that grabs our attention, not only in connection to Sfiras HaOmer, hayom yom echad laomer, but what about vayer vayibukar yom echad? When Hashem Yisbaruch is creating the world, it's yom echad. What do you mean yom echad? Be'echad b'shem. It should be Barishan. It's Yom Rishon. It's Sunday. It's the first in a sequence. So it ought to have been Vayer Vayibukar Yom Rishon, Yom Sheni. Why is it Yom Echad? Why is it Yom Echad LaOmer? Why at the outset of creation? And the narrative that opens the Chamisha Chumshei Torah there as well. It's an Inyan of Vayer Vayibukar Yom Echad. Why not Rishon? Explains Rav Moshe Shapiro Zatzal, based on the Sefer Yetzirah. Rav Moshe takes us to the following. When we look at this shorish, the etymology of Samach Pei Resh, it connotes the sense of connecting, of bonding, of connecting things together. Somebody who writes a sefer is taking different ideas, different chidushei Torah, and he's being machaber them. Hence, the one who pens such a work is appropriately labeled a machaber. That's exactly what he's doing. He's being machaber different ideas, different themes and topics, putting them together into a sefer. Mishnah and Sota, Perktes in Mishnah Beis, as far as city on a boundary, on a gvul, is thereby uniting within all those little townships and locales and making them part of that city. A sefer, counting is you, uniting members of Klal Yisrael all together. A sfira days is an Indian of chibur, of uniting things together, creating a unit, a cohesive, unified entity. That's the idea of Echad. So explains Rav Moshe, when we count Sfira, we're counting days. We're not counting away from something. We're counting days between Pesach and Shavuos to unite the two together, especially keeping in mind the Ramban and Chav Gimel Lamed Vav of Emor. The Ramban writes that Pesach and Shavuos is really Shnechad Samlam and Be'echad. It's two halves of one Yontif. Pesach begins the Yontif, the Yemei Sfiras HaOmer, serves as the Yemei Chol HaMoed, and then the culmination of the Yontif, of course, is Shavuos. Call that Seris. It's the end. The end of the Yontif called Pesach, two halves of a whole. Some Mela Sfiras HaOmer, in a sense, is connecting all the days together. But deeper than that, it's connecting it to what? It's connecting everything in life back to the originating source and the source of it all, of the days, of existence, of everything and anything in this world. The origin, the soul, the Makor, the Shorish, of course, is the Echad Yochad Umiyuchad HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Hence, when we count the days of the week, it's not going away from a Kodesh Baruch Hu. The Borei Olam, Fakert, on the contrary, it's going back to him. It's going back to Echad, Yochad, Miuchad. We count days. It's not Rishon Sheni. It's Echad. It all goes back. Everything in this world is always traced back to Echad, Yochad, Miuchad. So we have a Sfira. We connect people, put them all together. We have a Sefer, a book. We have a Sipur, a storyline. Take different motifs, different themes, and plots. We twist and build a beautiful, weave a nice tapestry. It all comes together into a sense of achdus. That's the idea of a sfira. It all comes down to echad, yochad, miuchad. Everything in life is traced the same way that we've been speaking repeatedly about the mitzvah of emunah, the yesod of an old tzaddik b'menosa yichye, that all the tzaddik mitzvahs all are traced back to one mitzvah, emunah. And the yesod of it all is emunah, but it's an emunah and an echad, yochad, miuchad, the beginning of it all. Hence, when we start the world of creation, it starts with the Beis. As the Maral explains, Beis is the first symbol of Pirud, first symbol of separation, because it all started with an Aleph. Who is the Aleph of the world? Writes the Medrash Osios Rabbi Akiva. Aleph Zeh HaKadosh Baruch Hu. God is called throughout all the Medrashim, the Alufa Shalom, the chief, the officer, the king of the world. Adds the Bnei Soschan Rego Yeshorim, many Chassidus is from as well. You look at the very Tzur of an Aleph, and what is it? A Vav in the middle, a Yud on top, and a Yud Yud on Badin. That's 26. Gematria Yud Kei Vav Kei. That's the Aleph of the world. So it all started with an Aleph. Then there's a Beis, a Bereishis, and that's a separation. That's a Pirud. You can have two parallel lines, explains the Maral, that go on ad infinitum, and they'll never meet. Two parallel lines. That's the idea of a Beis. That's the idea of a Pirud. Aleph is, everything comes back to Aleph, to the Echad Yochan Yuchad. Parenthetically, I mentioned that in the Guna Convention a number of years back. That's not coincidental. You talk about aguda achas. You're talking about, I'm making yourselves one aguda. You ever wonder? Take a look at the word. What is the word aguda? It starts with an aleph. That's the beginning of it all. And then what do you have? You have gimel, dalet, hey, vav. You have the first letters of the aleph bays. Aleph, but you skipped, unnoticingly, you skipped a bays. It was aleph, gimel, dalet, hey, vav. Aguda. What happened to the bays? Because the bays, the fianiest deity, is a steer to what an aguda is. Aguda is you're joining things together. Lulav. Tzorech Egen. Egen is the tie that binds the Dal and Minim together, the Lulav, the Hadassim, the Arabis. What's an Aguda? You started with an Aleph, it's about Achtos. And then what'd you have? Egen, Gimel and Dalet, but you skip the base because base is a symbol of Pirud. Things that are not connected. The Maral says when you have three, a third line can always connect two parallel lines. Shlosha, Sha'ochlu, Ka'achas, Azimun. When do you have a Zimun? Now with two people. Three, because the third one is Ma'achid, brings them all together again. And Aguda is Aleph, Gimel and Dalet, hey, Vav. But we skipped, quite expectedly, the Oz Beis, because that symbolizes, that connotes a sense of Pirud. So that's a good, we always come back to a Kodesh Baruch Hu, the source of it all. That's everything in the world, is always traced back to Echad Yochad Miuchad. Look what's happening in the world around us today. God shows us every once in a while who's in control, who's the master of the world, who controls anything and everything 24/7, 365. And that's a Kodesh Baruch Hu. It all has to come back to the source. With that in mind, let's share an unbelievable Chassam Sefer. It's a vart that appears at the back of his Chedushim and Masach HaSchulin, printed in the Kobe's Chuvas in Chelek Ches and Simon Nun Beis. It's also an idea that Bnei Yisoschar mentions in a footnote in his Mamore, Choche Kislev and Teves, and Maimer Beis in Os Yud Ches, in the Haggad. It's also in Mamore Shabbos, and Maimer Dalet and Os Gimel, something Rav Tzedek HaKohen alludes to as well in Kohen Tzimitcha Chelek Beis in Simon Nun Ches. On page 52, listen to this Chassam Sefer, Rav Tzedek, HaKohen, and Bnei Yisoschar, a Myridic ideal. Let's count. We know that the Osios and the Aleph Beis represent the creation of the world. Hashem is the Stalka Baraisa Boraomo. Using the Chav Beis, Osios, and the Aleph Beis, that's how you create various Tzirufei Osios. That's the Gemara, for example, of Brochus and Heyam and Aleph, the Yodea, Hayabetzala, Latzarif, Benes Osios, Shaman Nivru, Shemayim, and Aretz. You create, you make things Al Yodei Tzirufim. Various interconnections of the Chopes Osios of the Alabes. So if we take a look, explains the Chassam Sefer of Tzadik in the Bnei Yisoschar, if we want to create in the Olam HaGashmi. So we have three categories within the Osios of the Alabes. We have the single digits, we have the tens, and we have the hundreds. Now what's the largest number in the single digits? The ten. The nine. 10 already starts the reboy. So 9 in the single digits, that's the Os Tes. What's the largest in the tens? That's the Os Tzadi. That's 90. What's the largest in the hundreds? Even though Tuf represents 400, we have Osios Menavtsach. We have the Osios Sofios, the Chav Sofit, the Mem Sofit, the Nun Sofit, the Pei Sofit, and the Tzani Sofit. So the Tzani Sofit is the largest letter, and that has a value of 900. So the Tes, 9. The Tzadi, 90. And the Tzani Sofit, 900, the greatest combination you can have of creating things in this world is the tziruv of the largest number in the single digits, the tens and the hundreds. That's 999. What happens if you add 1 to 999? Dainu, you want to leave this world. You want to go outside of this world of the Gashmi. What do? You add an Aleph Gematri, Hebrew numerical equivalent of 1 to 999. You thus transform 99 into 1,000. But what is 1,000 in Hebrew? 1,000 is Aleph. Dainu, you added an Aleph 1 to 999. You left this world. And what did that do? It took you to the world of Aleph, 1,000. But what is Aleph? Aleph is the Aleph. It's going right back to the Aleph, to the Echad Yochad and Yuchad, to Hashem is the Aleph of the world. Aleph, Gematria 26, Gematria Yudke Vavke. Aleph, the Alufa Shalom, the master, the chief of the world, explains himself, Sefer B'nai Yisoschar. What do you think? You left this world. What did you do? And you just went right back to the Shoresh. You're not leaving and venturing beyond. You're tracing everything right back to the Shoresh, to the Makor, to the Echad Yochad Miuchad. You added an Aleph, a value of 1 to 999, and that turned you into Aleph, into 1,000, which is Aleph, which is right back to this where you started from. Even when you think you're leaving, you're just going right back to the beginning, because it all and always goes right back. Ach v'rach to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Phineas Daiti, we can add on the following. What is Aleph backwards? Aleph backwards, of course, is Pelet. Adiva Pella in the Hagdomad Eben Shlema, the girl writes, Aleph Hua Pele, Hua Nelam, Aleph backwards is Pella. What's the Musag? What's the concept of Pella? Pella, we know, the Ramo writes in Or Chaim and Simon Vov and Sifhei, the Ramo, based on the tour, we have the idea of Umafli, Mafli Lasus, we conclude Asher Yotzer. Rafuner is a Gavaldi Gemaimer Pachritzik and Pesach Maimer Tezvov. Umafli Lasus, we finish Asher Yotzer highlighting the body. And then right after the words, Umafli Lasus, that serves as the crucial link, as the bridge to Elokai Neshomash and Asata Bikirbi. Because what is a Pella? Writes the Ramah, Pella is the Chibur of Ruchni and Gashmi. The fact that Hashem Yisburg took a completely spiritual Ruchni Yistik and Neshoma and endowed it and placed it into a Gashmi Yistik and Goof, that is the ultimate Pella. That's the ultimate wonder of the world. That's Mafli Lasus. Hence, when we have the Koach HaDibur, it's an Indian of Hafla, Ishki Yafli Lindo Neder, because that's an expression that you have a Ruchni Yistik and Neshoma within your Gashmi Yistik and Goof. Anytime you manifest that, you exhibit that, that's an Indian of Pella. That's why in the Ramam, Inyone Hafla, encompass therein, Nedorim, Naziris, Inyone Shavuos, that's all an Indian of Pella. What is Pella Lechiba Ruchni Agashmi? Stephanian Staiti, it's very geschmack. You left this world, you went out of 999. That's the greatest expression, the Yolam Agashmi, 999. Then you added an Aleph and you went to 1,000, you went to Aleph. What is that Pella? When you were in this Gashmi stick world and you left it, what did you do? You went right back to the beginning. When you thought you were leaving the Yolam Agashmi, you were going right back to the Aleph of the world, to the source of it all, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And that goof is a Pella. Aleph, you get to the end of Aleph. So let's get to the end. Aleph, Lamed, Pei. You get to the end. Aleph, Lamed, Pei. And then what? You go right back to the beginning. Pei, Lamed, Aleph. You leave the world of Gashmi. You go right back to the source of the Olam Ruchni. That is the Chibur. Aleph is the Chibur. Aleph, the Chibur. Ruchni and Gashmi. 1,000 represents starting a world of Nitzlius, of the Maitlam and Asmat. A Ruchni is take a world, but in the end, it's bringing you right back to the beginning. That itself is the Chibur of the Olam Gashmi, the Olam Ruchni. That's the ultimate Pella. Aleph, backwards, Aleph and Pella, that's the Chibur, the synthesis of Ruchni and Gashmi. The Melo. If that's a Kodesh Baruch Hu, the Aleph of the world, and that's what we highlight, we're counting people, we're counting days, it's all about bringing everything together. Memelo. And let's get to the end of the Sphira. We get to the end of the Sphira, and what Parsha almost always precedes the Yontav of Shavuos, the Torah writes in Or Chaim Simitov Chavches, the Parsha of Bamidbar. How do we begin? Bimidbar Sinai. Writes Rabbeinu Ephraim, one of the Bali Atesis. What's Gematria of Bimidbar Sinai? 378 Gematria of Bisholo. Midbar Sinai, Gematria 376, Gematria Shalom. You know, when you're ready to get the Torah, when you're Bisholom, when you're Bimidbar Sinai, how are you going to get the Torah? Vayichan Shom Yisrael Negen Har, Rashi citing the Mechilta, Yates Beis, Embraces, Yisrael Loshen Yochid, Kish Echad Bulei Bechad, Ameila Ezra Yitzhak Isaac and Rav Gedalia Shor, and all the Balei Moshev explain, it's not Stamin in Yan Segulei, it's a prerequisite. You want to get the Torah, Hashem says, I'm only giving the Torah if you're together. The Torah itself is a Ma'achid. Torah is Kutcha Bruch of Yisov, Araisa Chadu, Zohar Nachrim, Osain Gilmom, and Aleph. Hashem is Echad Yochim, Yuchad writes the Maral. Hashem is only going to connect to us if we are now Mechad. Mikam Chayso, Gay Echad Baretz. If we are Keish Echad, Bulei Mechad, then Hashem will give us the Torah that will make us all connected as one. We are now Mechad. Hashem is the Echad Yochim, Yuchad. The Torah will thereby unite us. And Mamela Kutcha Bruch of Yisov, the Araisa Chadu, we all come together as one. How do we get ready for that Shavuos? We get ready, what? Bimidbar Sinai, Gematria B'Sholom. We get ready on the heels of Kisha Chabalei Vechot. Amelo, we get to the end of a Sfira. So what is a Sfira? A Sfira is counting the people and bringing us all together. But not just counting the people, bringing us all together, counting the days. And when we finish counting the days and bringing all the days together and uniting them back to Echad, Yom Echad Lomer, it's at that precise time when we read Parshas Bamidbar going into Shavuos and Tzman Matan Torah Seder, where what is the gist of Parshas Bamidbar? It's a Sfira. It's counting people. When we finish counting the days, that mamash is synchronized with counting the people and then the context of Parshas Bamidbar to bring them all together as one. That is the only way we can get the Torah. When we recognize that we bring all the days of existence together as one, all the people, all Yidden together as one, we're all together as one. We recognize that it all comes down to Echad, Yachad, and Yuchad. Then and only then can we get the Torah that will unite with Hashem, who is Echad, Yachad, and Yuchad, with Klai Yisrael as Kish Echad, Belev Echad. Then Kuch Baruch Hu Yisrael Reis Echadu. That's the Zohar Nachimos, Ayin Gimel Man Aleph. But let's end the following. We mentioned this in the past. It's a Moridic Aremes, and with this we'll close Yehuda Shaviv and the Sefer Bein Haftor LaParsha. Sefer Parshas Bamidbar is the parsha that almost always directly precedes Shavuos. And if you look at Krach Yud, volume 10 in the Encyclopedia Talmudis, you'll see a listing of all the Haftiris that Ashkenazim, Sfardim, Taimanim, Edut, Mizrach, the world over, we always had different minhagim. One Haftari, you look at your Otsko, Kan Matchilim Ashkenazim, Kan Masayim Asfardim, this is Minach Chabad, this is what, everybody has different minhagim. Kai, so believe it or not, all year long, there isn't one time we can't agree on saying the same Haftarah. We can't start from the same place and end. Even if we have the same selection, the same choice narrative from the Nevi'im that we all lay, but we all either start or end in a different place. Believe it or not, there's only one time. You take a look at the list at the back of volume 10 of Encyclopedia Talmudis in Yoni Haftarah. Oh, say there's only one time throughout the course of the Jewish calendar year that every single Jew, Ashkenazi, Sfardi, Taimani, Eitan Mizra, Chabad, Satmar, a Breslov, you name it, every one of the colors of the segments of Klai Yisrael, every single person does what lanes the same Haftarah. And what is that Haftarah? It's taken from Hosea, Perek Beis, right at the beginning, via Mispar B'nei Yisrael, counting, that's Parshas Bamidbar. This will be Kecholayama Sholo Yima Velo Yisafer, and then continues Pasuk Beis writes the Navi Yosheya V'nik Bitzu B'nei Yehuda B'nei Yisrael Yachtov. I'm going to gather all of Klai Yisrael together as one. V'samolam Rosh Echad, and they will have one Rosh Echad V'yolam and Aretz. You want to come out of Golas Klai Yisrael V'nik Bitzu? We got to be one with the Rosh Echad. We all have to be Tachas Hakadosh Baruch Hu Melech Hamashiach Mekoro. It's all about coming together. You know the one time the whole year that every single Jew can agree on saying the same exact Haftarah and start at the same exact place and finish at the same exact place. It is the Haftarah Parshas Bamidbar when we talk about coming together as one. And it makes sense because that's the Shabbos and the Haftarah that always directly precedes the Yontif of Shavuos. You want to get the Torah, my dear Klai Yisrael. It's got to be predicated Mavusas on one major Inyan, and that is Achdus. I need you to be together as one. Only then am I giving you the Torah Kadoshah. When v'nik mitzu tachas rosh echad, then and only then will I go in and give you my Torah. That's the Haftarah before we get into a Shavuos, wherein we see the culmination of bringing all the days together as Echad, of bringing all the people together as Echad. My dear Klai Yisrael, we want this Man Matan Torah Seder to be in our Seder HaKadoshah with Melech HaMashiach, with the ultimate Rosh Echad, and Tachasim Sholom, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Echad Yochad and Yuchad, with Binyan Baya Shlisha like never before. Then, dear Klai Yisrael, we got to get together as one. We got to stay together. We got to stick together. We have to love one another, never stop loving one another, no matter our differences. There might be many differences, many colors, shapes, sizes, backgrounds, but bring it all together by this Shavuos. It's got to be v'nik mitzu tachas rosh echad. It's got to be Klai Yisrael. We're going to get together, kish echad v'leiv echad, loving one another, caring for one another, and genuinely davening sincerely, wholeheartedly for everyone's refuah shleima bekarov, to bring all of Klai Yisrael together in health with gezunt and nachas and kol mila demeta. For the Mashiach Tzidkenu, Mehera of Yemeinu, way before the Shavuos, have a gewaltige day, Hatzloch and Brochen Olanyan.